हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सिमेंस प्रोग्रामिंग ट्यूटोरियल। दिस इज़ लेसन 10। सो इन टुडेज लेसन वी विल सी एनालॉग इनपुट प्रोग्रामिंग। ओके, तो हाउ टू प्रोग्राम एनालॉग इनपुट, हाउ टू डू स्केलिंग इन TIA पोर्टल, वी विल सी इन टुडेज वीडियो। सो बिफोर स्टार्ट द वीडियो, लेट्स क्लियर द सम पॉइंट। सो व्हाट्स एनालॉग इनपुट डिवाइसेस? ओके, विच आर द एनालॉग इनपुट डिवाइसेस? सो प्रेशर ट्रांसमीटर, टेम्परेचर कंट्रोलर, VFD एनालॉग फीडबैक, लेवल ट्रांसमीटर, दिस आर द टाइप्स ऑफ द एनालॉग इनपुट डिवाइसेस। ओके, सो व्हाट कुड बी द टाइप्स ऑफ दिस इनपुट डिवाइसेस? इट कुड बी 4 to 20 mA। द इनपुट ऑफ दिस एनालॉग इनपुट कुड बी 4 to 20 mA, 0 to 20 mA, 0 to 10 V, और -10 to +10 V. So in today's video we will take one example. So we will consider one pressure transmitter which range is 0 to 50 bar, and the type of this pressure transmitter is 4 to 20 mA type. It means it gives the 4 to 20 mA feedback to our PLC card. Okay, so let's start the lesson for TIA portal. Open the TIA portal. So very first thing, we need to add an analog input module in our device configuration. So we will add the analog input module. Go to device, hardware catalog. Go to AI analog input. So these are the type of the analog input cards. Okay, so first is 4 into 13 bit, means 4 channel. Okay, this is also 4 into 16 bit. This bit means it shows the resolutions. So based on your catalog number, you have to select the proper catalog number from these configurations, right? So this is RTD cards, this is TC cards, and this is for energy meter. So we will select our type. So I will select 4 channel 13 bit because I have this hardware, right? Drag and drop here. Okay, now we have added the hardware in our device configuration. So let's check the address of this analog input. Go to properties of that module. This card is 4 channel card, right? So we will have the four input for this card. So 4 addresses will be there. Let's go to IO addresses. Okay, the start address is 128 and the ending address is 135. Just click on analog input. Okay, the 4 channels are there: channel 0, channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. So for first channel, that is channel 0. So here we can select our type of analog input device. So in our case, we have selected 4 to 20 mA. Milliampere means it is current type, right? So select current type. Here by default it's voltage type, so we need to change it to current. We'll change it to current. Okay. Then there are options in current range. It's 0 to 20 mA or 4 to 20 mA. So we'll select 4 to 20 mA because our device type is 4 to 20 mA. Okay. Go down. Okay. And the address of this channel is IW128. You can see here. IW128 for channel 0. For channel 1 it's IW130, for channel 2 IW132. Okay, so we will check for channel 0, IW128. Okay, now we'll go to a program block. Okay, we will write program in main block. You can write in any FC or OV, anywhere. Take one empty box. Take norm x. Okay, so what happen in any analog devices? Okay, it gives us a in value in pulses, right? It gives the value in 0 to 32 7 67, right? So we have to take minimum 0, maximum 32,767, right? And what's our input address? IW128. Here we need to select data type integer 2. Real, okay. We will define one tag here, analog input value in real. Okay. Global new tag. Okay, defined. Now we'll take one more empty box for scaling buffers. Take scale x box. Okay. Now, what is the range of our transmitter? It's 0 to 50 bar, right? So minimum should be 0, maximum should be 50, right? And copy this address, just give it to here, real 2. We can show in real also our output hit. So analog input actual value. Define the tag, it will take next address automatically, right? So what happened here? The input range is from 0 to 32,767, right? So this our analog input transmitter gives us the value between 0 to 32,767. Okay, so it converts into real, it normalizes this value, and we show it between 0 to 50, right? The scale is between 0 to 50, so that's why our actual value is between 0 to 50 based on the input value of 0 to 32,767. So just we'll run the program, start simulation. Load. Run. Okay. So now we have this is our main input, analog input, right? But now actually I have not configured the analog input any device, so we will force it, right? Modify Okay. Actually, this is input. That's why it's not possible to modify, right? So for an example, to show you, I will just change this set. Okay, now we will modify this. Okay, means if the value is 500 for the input, then we have the output 0.76. Suppose we have the value of 2000, then the actual pressure is 3.05, right? We'll modify now 4000. The actual value is 6.10. If we have the value 32000, it means the pressure is 48.82. Okay, in this way, it shows the